Thank you. Colleagues, I would like to say that I'm not quite sure why we are discussing this situation in the Czech media environment here today. I believe the European Parliament should be addressing systemic issues in those member states that fail to respect fundamental democratic principles and where independent journalism faces institutional obstacles. The Czech Republic certainly is not one of them. It goes without saying that the action of Andrej Babiš, the leader of the party that I represent here in the Parliament and that has been referred to, was unacceptable. I have indeed myself raised the issue with him, publicly denounced his actions, and publicly asked him to provide full account of what exactly happened, what his role in the matter was. I also called on him to facilitate the resolution of the situation by resigning. He is not any longer a member of the government. But the Czech Republic has functioning democratic institutions whose capability of dealing with such problems remains unrestrained. We have conflict of interest legislation in place which has prompted Andrej Babiš to place his media and other companies in a trust fund. These institutions are well placed to assess whether that is sufficient. But all of that is just one single case. It might be interesting to note that the latest Press Freedom Index put out by a respectable organization, Reporters Without Borders, ranks the Czech Republic 23rd out of 180 countries in the world, well above France, which ranks 39th, or the UK, which is 40th, or Italy, which is 52nd. Czech media and Czech journalists are free to do their job properly. I would say that I see a much bigger reason of concern, and that is my country's ambiguous and rather passive European policies. I don't think this is something we should be debating here either, but I would understand that many of you would like to understand an increasing ambiguity in EU issues in the Czech Republic and other EU countries as well, their passivity and ever stronger tendency to see the European integration process in purely financial terms. But again, this is an issue common to many countries, not just the Czech Republic. It seems that the Czech politicians, including President Miloš Zeman, have forgotten what brought us into the EU ranks in the first place. I hope that the Czech people will choose truly European leaders in the general election this fall, and especially the presidential elections next January. That would surely bring a welcome break for many, including myself. The Czechs, as well as other EU nations, need real leaders to actively shape the debate on a number of issues, from Brexit and the future European integration to pressing security and other challenges on which we are often slow and weak. We need decisions on the enforcement. I want a Czech debate on these issues, as well as I want a Czech debate on Europe. Instead of discussing the failure of one Czech politician in one single issue, however important it may be, we should focus on working towards a reform of the EU. Time, rather than EU institutions, will tell whether Europe will develop into a multi-speed bloc or whether it will further integrate. That will be naturally decided by our own ability to come to agreements on specific problems and challenges. So let's first make clear what these problems are and let's start dealing with them. Czech journalism, as well as the need for a swift independent investigation into the recordings of the former First Deputy Prime Minister, is not one of them. Thank you.